In Creo Parametric, you can use multi-body modeling for performing local operations. Let me show you what I mean by that. Here we have a fuel cap and we want to hollow it out, so we'll use the shell command. And I will select the surface to remove. Let's change the thickness that we want. Let's change it to a value of 2 and then hit the check mark. And now we have a constant wall thickness. But in this particular situation, it shelled out the grips around the cap as well. We don't want to shell the grips. So let's see how we can do that using techniques from Creo Parametric 6.0 and earlier. Let's delete the original shell command. I could edit definition, but let me show you from scratch. Let's go to the shell command. Again, I will select this particular surface over here. Let's change the thickness to 2. And then on the options tab, we can choose which surfaces that we want to exclude. And you could pick these surfaces for the grips one by one, but that can be pretty tedious. You can also use the details button for advanced selection methods like seed and boundary. The problem with what I've done so far is right now by selecting the bottom surface to remove, I'm not able to select it. So let's cancel out of here. Let's go back to the references tab. Let's remove the surface that we had already removed. Go back to the options tab. Let's then go to details. Let's add in a surface set. Now we can select the bottom surface as our seed surface for seed and boundary. Then I can pick this surface here and hold down the control key to add the other surface to the bounding surfaces. Now we need to exclude some surfaces. We need to exclude that bottom surface. Hold down the control key and select these other two surfaces. So in that way, you can see it was a very complicated selection method in order to get those surfaces that we want to exclude from the shelling operation. Then we can go back to the references tab, activate the remove surfaces collector, pick the bottom surface to remove, hit the check mark. And again, we're able to achieve it, but it was just very, very complicated. Let's see how we can use multi-body modeling in order to make this easier. Let's delete the shell feature. And this time, before we perform the shell operation, let's use the split body command. We'll choose split body. Let's select the body that we want to split, which is body 1, the only body in the model. And for the splitting object, I will select this surface over here. And even though I've only got 1/2 of the surface selected, it automatically extends the splitting object. It automatically treats it as a cylinder. I'm going to use the flip button to flip to the outside so that the body 2 will contain just the grips. That's good. Let's hit the check mark or middle mouse button. And so now you can see that we've got body 1 in here. If I hide it, you can see that the only visible body are the grips. Let's bring back body 1, and then we can hide body 2. And that way you can see body 1 is just the main body of the fuel cap. Let's bring back body 2. Let's rename it just to keep track of stuff. Let me call it grip surfaces. All right, that is good. Now let us perform the shell operation. We'll hit the shell command and I'll pick the surface to be removed. Let's specify our thickness of 2. Hit the check mark, middle mouse button. Now all that we have to do is merge our two bodies together. Let's go to Boolean operations. We'll modify body 1. For the modifying bodies, we'll pick the grip surfaces body. And I'm not going to keep the bodies. I'm going to let it be consumed by the operation. Let's hit the check mark or the middle mouse button. And that way, it was much easier to achieve what we wanted to instead of those complicated selection methods. If you take a look in the bodies folder, the symbol next to the second body is actually dimmed out because it's been consumed by the operation. So in that way, you can use multi-body modeling for performing local operations in a simple manner. I hope you enjoyed this video. For more information, please visit www.creowindchill.com. If you learned something from this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you like this video, please click the subscribe button to be informed when new videos are uploaded. Thank you very much.